Mitogen-activated protein kinase, or MAPK, signaling pathways play an important role in signal transduction in eukaryotic cells, where they modulate events including cell cycle progression, development, apoptosis, and differentiation. MAPK pathways can be activated through diverse mechanisms, including G-protein-coupled receptors, receptor tyrosine kinases, inflammatory cytokines, and environmental stressors. MAPK pathways are organized in three tiers of kinases, consisting of a MAP kinase, or MAPK, an activator of MAP kinase, MAP kinase kinase, and a MAP kinase kinase kinase, or MAC. There are several distinct MAPK pathways, including the extracellular signal-related kinases, or MAPK-ERK, and the stress-activated pathways, P38-MAPK, SAPK-JUNK, and ERK5-BMK1. Here, we will review a canonical MAPK-ERK pathway activated through a receptor tyrosine kinase. Phosphotyrosine residues on the cytoplasmic tail of activated receptor tyrosine kinases serve as docking sites for adaptor proteins, such as growth factor receptor binding protein 2, or GRB2, which binds via its circ homology 2 domain, SH2. GRB2 recruits the guanine nucleotide exchange factor, SOS, co-localizing it with RAS at the plasma membrane. GDP is exchanged for GTP, and RAS is activated. Activated RAS can now interact with the first of the three tiers of the MAPK pathway, the MAP3K, or MEK, which in the case of the MAPK-ERK pathway is RAF, or rapidly accelerated fibrosarcoma. RAF proteins are represented by ARAF, BRAF, and CRAF in the MAPK-ERK pathway. RAF proteins appear to be stabilized in an inactive state by association with the 14-3-3 protein. Upon interaction with RAS, RAF is released from its interaction with the 14-3-3 protein. It is phosphorylated on regulatory residues in its N-terminus and forms homo or heterodimers with other RAF molecules, resulting in fully activated RAF complexes. Fully activated RAF in turn phosphorylates MEK1 and MEK2, the second tier kinases, or MEKs, of the MAPK-ERK pathway. MEK1 and MEK2 must be phosphorylated on two serine residues to be fully activated. MEK1 and MEK2 are dual specificity kinases that can phosphorylate their targets, ERK1 and ERK2, on tyrosines, serines, or threonine residues. ERK1 and ERK2 represent the third and final tier, or the MAP kinase, of the MAPK-ERK pathway. These kinases are serine threonine kinases that phosphorylate a variety of effector molecules. Once they are dually phosphorylated by MEK1 or MEK2, ERK1 and ERK2 can enter the nucleus to interact with the FOXO, ETS, and MYC family transcription factors, among others, to influence the activity of genes involved in the cell cycle, growth, and metabolism. ERK1 and ERK2 also interact with the ribosomal S6 kinase, P90RSK, in the cytoplasm to influence protein translation. Activated ERK can interact with BAD to influence apoptosis signaling and can interact with mTORC1 to regulate PI3K signaling as well.